Hello students, today I like to talk about the topic wireless charging. In this, first I will give some basic definition of wireless charging, then I will explain various types of wireless charging, then I will explain components of wireless charging, then I will mention main advantages and some of the limitations of wireless charging. So what is wireless charging? So every day we will be charging our mobile phones, we will be charging our emergency light, we will be charging our MP3. So like that, we are charging many electronic gadgets. Any of the electronic gadgets require a cable. That is, an electric cable is needed to charge. So we call it as wired charging. Now, wireless charging means we don't require any electric cable for charging. So we can put it in the simple term as charging the batteries without the use of cables. So nowadays cell phones can be charged wirelessly, laptops, computers, MP3 players, robots, and even some of the electric cars can be charged without the need of cable. There are mainly three types of wireless charging. First one is resonance charging. Second one, inductive charging. Third one is known as radio charging. Now let us see the first type, that is resonance charging. So as the name indicates, resonance. So when frequency of two objects are matched, automatically both will be vibrating at a infinite amplitude. That is known as resonance. So in this type of charging, the same concept is adopted. So in this, two copper coils are used. One is called as transmitter. The second one is known as receiver. Also in this diagram, this is primary coil, that is called as transmitter. This is secondary coil, that is called as receiver. Now both the coils are having same frequency of vibration. So if I apply a vibration here, it will vibrate at a frequency. So this frequency of the secondary coil matches with the primary coil. So both will be vibrating at a high amplitude. So this vibration later will be converted to electric current. So the energy from primary coil is transmitted to the secondary coil by means of resonance. That is why this is called as resonance charging. This kind of charging technique is used in equipments which need large amount of power. For example, robots, then vacuum cleaners, then laptop, computers. So all these equipments need high amount of power. For charging such equipments, we will be using this resonance charging. Next one is known as inductive charging. So the basic concept of electromagnetic induction is whenever a coil cuts the magnetic flux, and EMF will be induced. So this concept is employed in charging. So there is a transmitter coil here, this is a receiver coil. Now an alternate current is passed through the transmitter coil. Now this alternate current, it will keep on changing. So the magnetic flux also keep on changing direction. So it is equivalent to change in magnetic field. So due to this change in magnetic field, an electric current will be induced in this receiver coil. Now this electric current will be in AC form. Now later this AC will be converted to DC for charging battery. Now the current induced in this coil will be in AC form. Now later AC is converted to DC for charging battery. This kind of charging is mainly used for mid-size items like MP3 players, electric toothbrushes, etc. Next one is radio charging. Now in this there is a transmitter which will transmit the radio waves. Now there will be an antenna for receiving this radio waves. Now this radio waves are later used for charging the battery. So this kind of charging is used for small size items like watches, hearing aids and small cell phones. In this radio charging there is a transmitter. This transmitter will be transmitting the radio waves. There will be a receiver antenna for receiving these radio waves. Now this radio waves will then fed for converting it to electric current. So there will be a voltage amplifier, there will be a capacitor, all these things will be used for converting this radio waves to DC current. This kind of charging is mainly used in small size items like watches, hearing aids, small cell phones. Now the design of wireless charging can be summarized from this radio charging. The three components are the first one is a transmitter. Second one, there will be an antenna. This antenna will be used for catching the signals transmitted. Then finally this antenna will transmit all the signals to the receiver. Later there from the receiver using some electronic circuits it will be converted into direct current. So transmitter, actually it is a power source. So from this power source the energy will be transmitted to the receiver. So normally the signals will be transmitted in microwave range, normally around the frequency of 900 megahertz. Next one is antennas. This antenna will be acting as a mediator between transmitter and receiver. So the main work of antenna is to catch all the signals and supply to the receiver. So while supplying, the impedance and gain should be matching, because at higher gains we can achieve higher transmission efficiency. Now the receiver purpose is to charge the battery of the equipment. Now rectifier circuit will be used for converting AC signal, and finally with the help of a capacitor and a resistor we will get a desired output DC current. So this DC current will be used for charging battery. Now the main benefits of wireless charging are the convenience and freedom. Now the main beauty of this wireless charging is we can use it for charging multiple devices. But in the case of wired charging, only one device can be charged. Since we are not using any cables, electronic wastes such as plastics, packaging materials, it can be greatly reduced. Now there are certain limitations for wireless charging. A few limitations are, we can use it only for a small distance. We cannot keep the wireless equipment away, because if suppose we are using a mobile phone for wireless charging, we have to keep it on the pad itself. We cannot keep that mobile phone elsewhere. So the distance between this transmitter and receiver, it should be very small. Then only the receiver will be getting the enough signals for charging the battery. Now in the case of electric cars, it is still in development phase, so a lot of charging stations are not there. So this is a drawback in the case of electric cars. Now the efficiency of the charging and compared to wired charging, it is less, because during the transmission lot of power will be lost. So this is one of the main limitation of wireless charging. Hopefully all these limitations will be solved in future, and I hope we can achieve this wireless charging for almost all the equipments. Thank you.